Let's go on an adventure here and show you guys how we got to this on this Bronco, 2022 Bronco. Basically gonna have a video series here showing you what it took to get to this. Filming?
Mm-hmm.
It's filming?
Mm-hmm.
Is it filming?
It's filming.
It's filming. All right, we're filming. All right, Nathan, this is what we're going to work on for the next couple days here. This is a 2022 Ford Bronco Wild Track Sasquatch Edition. Pretty cool vehicle. It's completely bone stock with, what, 260 miles on it? Something really low. Got driven around town and got dropped off. It's pretty cool. I like it. Neat interior. This is cool. Look at this, guys. Whoa. It's a Bronco. So yeah, we got this truck. I did some looking on the internet to kind of get some initial ideas and figure out how much space is in there. Nathan, can you kill that background for us? So it's a four-door Bronco. It's got a good amount of space back here in the back. Got a little flip open floor area, the jack. So, good amount of space. And supposedly, what I've seen online, doing my research, there's a 4-inch speaker here in the dash. Another one on the passenger side. And then there's speakers down here in the kick panel. And then there is speakers up here. Some pods or something right here. Supposedly there's a 4-inch speaker in there. So there's 4 4s and 2 6.5s, and this one's they come with a B&O system, and it has a subwoofer mounted over here in the side panel. But this one is not a B&O. This is a bass audio system. So I guess it's radio power. So it's powered off the infotainment center in the center of the dash here, which is really cool. It has a really large screen. Oh, there's a button. Turn this thing on. Yeah, 265.1 miles. Nice big screen. Really slick looking vehicle. So I did some looking online, kind of watched some other people change their dash speakers with some inexpensive dash speakers, and they said it made it sound better. But so I have some initial ideas. So we looked at the vehicle, did some brainstorming, and we basically wanted to come up with a really crazy audio system for this thing. So what our plan is to put some really top of the line Focal equipment in this vehicle, Mosconi amplifiers and such. So we have here, we have a cart, nice big cart. And this cart's what, 4 feet wide and 2 feet deep. So there's a lot of gear on this. So from looking at vehicle online and kind of made some educated guesses on what we're going to do in here, we decided to order all this gear for this vehicle. So we're going to start out with, got a bunch of different stuff here. We'll see if we actually can use all this gear. That would be awesome. So this is a Focal K2 Power KX3 kit. So it's a 6.5, 3-inch and tweeter. So we're gonna put this, hopefully. We're gonna do the 6.5 in the kick panel. We're gonna do the 3 up here in the dash and a tweeter. Do that on both sides. And then I saw this online, I looked at it, and I'm like, wow, it'd be really cool to add another speaker there. So hopefully we can fit another one of these woofers, which we got a pair of them here. Got another pair here. Let's actually flip this up and open this. Thanks, Nathan. So this is a really awesome kit. We do this kit a lot, actually. It's one of our faves. Actually have this in my, or had this in my personal car for a long time. So 3-inch mid, iconic yellow cone, which is actually Kevlar. That's why it's yellow. It's a Kevlar sandwich cone. So super awesome mid-bass driver. I'm gonna try to get that in the kick panel. Pair of mids, pair of tweets in the dash, and it comes with a bunch of other accessories, passive crossovers and some pods and stuff to mount the mids. We're not going to be using the passives because we're going to do what's called a fully active system with a DSP. So we got that full set. We got an extra set of mid-bass drivers. Got a set of Kevlar 4-inch components, which we're going to try to put in the back pods. I got an extra set because I thought I was going to move on to that now. I thought I was going to do it a 4-inch. I might do a 4-inch in the middle of the dash too as a center channel. We're going to look at that situation. Because if you look up in here, there's a little pocket right here. And we're going to try to do a center channel actually. We're going to add a center and we have enough amplification and DSP to do that. So option, my first choice would be doing a half set of these in the front. We'll do a 4-inch tweeter in the center for center channel. Just in case we can't fit that in there, I got an Illusion Audio C3CX. Hold that, Nathan. Yeah. So this kit, actually let's look at this kit real quick. Uh-oh, need a blade. Don't have a blade. Let's open this up and see what, show everyone what this looks like. Little baby. Oops. Awesome looking kit. Same 4-inch Kevlar cone mid-range and a inverted Kevlar dome tweeter. Just smaller tweeter than the KX3.
Smaller crossovers too.
Smaller, everything's smaller. It's a shrunken, honey, I shrunk the speakers. Remember that movie? You remember that movie?
No. Nope.
Honey, I Shrunk the Kids? No?
Nope.
Come on. I must be old. Right, let's open this up. So this is plan A. We have plan B here, just in case we don't have the real estate up there to fit that. And this is packaged well. This is a really cool speaker. So this is a Illusion Audio C3CX. It's a 3-inch mid with a little tiny tweeter mounted right there in the middle. So very compact. Plays from about, it'll, in this particular system, we're gonna play 300 and up. About 300 hertz and up, so.
On the center?
On the center channel, yeah. So we have some options for a center channel. Get rid of this trash. I'll put it in my pocket for now. Put the razor blade away. Might need that again. So that covers, this is like front speakers here, or front and rear speakers. So we'll do a three-way, extra mid-bass in the door, hopefully. We're gonna try our best to do that. I have no clue how much depth is in that door, or we can even do it. We're gonna have to actually take it apart and see before we start cutting holes. We're gonna do some measurements and figure that out. So hopefully we can get two mid basses on each side. Reason being why we want two mid basses on each side is because we want a lot of mid bass. And we're doing something a little out of the ordinary. Let me get rid of this trash. So, front stage. So, now we have a pile of amps, right? So, this is the Mosconi Pro 530, which is a five-channel amplifier. This is our crazy system we came up with. And we're gonna try our hardest to get all this integrated into the vehicle and make it look stock. It's not gonna look stock. Most of it's gonna look stock. We're gonna utilize as many factory locations as we can. We're gonna hopefully add some more, another speaker location in the door. So this is a five channel, 1300 and it's like around 1400 watts of power when all said and done. So it's a five channel amplifier. We're actually going to be, you see we have two of them here. Normally systems we do, we'll do two of these to power the whole vehicle. One for the left side of the car, one for the right side of the car. In this case, we're actually going to run one of these Pro 530s to the left front speaker system. Basically, two sixes or one six, a three and tweeter. So we're going to run this basically in a three-channel mode, bridge three-channel mode, to run the left speaker. We have another one to run the right speaker. So that's an insane amount of power, about 2,800 watts RMS on the front speakers. Crazy, right? But when you set everything up properly, gains and all that fun stuff, do it properly, you can actually get away with running that much power and have an insane amount of clarity and all that fun stuff. So, we've got DSP accessories here, so set that aside. So we got 2600 watts of power on the front speakers, then we have 130 watts by four channel amplifier from Mosconi. This is going to be running the center channel, which is either a half set of the ES100Ks or the C3CX, not sure yet, we're going to figure that out. And then the other two channels are going to be running the rears. And then, so we got crazy with 2600 plus, this is 500 and something watts running the rears and center. And then we're gonna do, let's see.
Come on, Nathan.
Let's see if the boxes will fit that. We're gonna do one. Two. I think it'll fit, see? If the boxes fit, it'll fit. Right?
That's how it works.
Oh, there we go. See? Look. That was a good guess from looking at pictures online. So we're going to do three K2 power 10s in a hopefully vented cabinet so we can get the most bass possible, period. We want this thing to be crazy loud with excellent sound quality. So we got that. And then we got, check this out, it's crazy. 1,000 watts for that one, 1,000 watts for this one, and 1,000 watts for this one. So then we got, you know, we gotta do that. We gotta put that in there, and then we have to put this amp in here somewhere for the mids and highs, or the center channel. And then we have two of these, which I'm not gonna unbox the other one. We have two of these, bam, bam. I don't know how we'll fit these in here. Mount them up here or something, I don't know. It's gonna be crazy. So we got two of those, one of those, three of those, three tens. And then, we got this guy. This is our digital signal processor. And this is gonna do all the crossing over, all the, can't get the box open. So this right here is the Mosconi digital sound digital signal processor. So this is 12 channels, 12 channel DSP. So we'll have a basically an amplifier channel. When we're all said and done, we'll have an amplifier channel for every single speaker in the car. The only thing that's going to be running passive through a passive crossover network are the rears. So we'll have to install these. And this basically takes the signal in and then it splits it to the mid bass and the tweeter. So we'll actually have to use these little passives for the rears, because we would need to do another DSP in there to make it completely fully active. But yeah, so it's a little bit of gear. Totally abnormal.
A lot of power.
Lots of power. Lots and lots and lots and lots of power. So yeah, that's what we're up against. That's our challenge. It's gonna be a lot of fun. I have some ideas in my mind about the enclosure. Let's just have to start doing measurements and designing and actually figure out if it'll actually work, because sometimes you'll have an idea in your mind and it won't work because it doesn't physically fit. So we have to come up with a very creative way to install all this gear, make it look nice. Obviously, this is not going to be a stealth install. It's going to take up most of the cargo space, but the whole purpose for this vehicle is to have an amazing stereo system, you know, and it needs to play every genre of music really well. We want lots of bass, tons of mids and highs. We're going to do, you know, good sound quality, staging, imaging, the whole nine yards, and lots of cool fabrication and stuff like that. So definitely an exciting project. It's a lot of gear, as you can see. Did I miss anything? Oh, so we got all the gear and we have ideas on where it's all going to fit in the car. We also want to, first things first that we're going to do is we're gonna start coming up with ideas, make sure speakers fit. Like, we need to make sure the KX 3 mid bass driver fits in the kick panel, make sure the panel will go back on and see how that all works out. Then we'll move on to you know, exploring the dash locations to make sure that we can fit the 3-in tweeter up there. I don't know exactly what we're gonna do. We'll probably end up doing something custom so it looks cool. We don't have to keep it behind factory grills and make it look stock. We can make it showy, because this vehicle is actually going to be go to shows and stuff, so it can be showy and flashy and it's going to be really cool. But we got all the gear, but as far as the foundation goes, we actually have, this is a sound treatment. I know you guys have seen us do sound treatment. This is the black hole mat. So we got, we got 14 of these sheets, and we're gonna,
those are big sheets too.
Yeah, they're like double sheets. 14 double sheets, so it's like 28 sheets of sound treatment. Got all this here. I think it's like 180 pounds of sound treatment. So we got that. We're gonna do the whole vehicle. We're gonna rip the whole, not rip, we're gonna professionally take out the interior. I would like to say rip out the interior, but we're gonna disassemble the whole vehicle. We'll probably end up pulling the top off of the truck, and then so we can actually get more light in there, since the top does come off, give us more light and be able to see what's going on easier. So we'll end up disassembling the whole truck, pulling everything out. We'll go ahead and start sound treating the whole vehicle and rewind. Need to make sure what we're doing, as far as speaker locations, write down all the speaker wires that we need to run, where everything's going to go, so we can start coming up with a plan there, get it sound treated, and then we'll move into figuring out maybe the enclosure or the doors. I'm not sure exactly where we're gonna go with this today. But first is getting the vehicle prepped, hooking it up to a power supply, getting it protected with some paint protection film, and pull it apart and go ahead and start knocking this thing out. Alright, so we need some thinner. I'm gonna try to go cut this on. Oh, we need to make a smaller roll. You think it'll work, Don? Well, you know, you'll find out later. What do we need? 7 inch?
If that.
Want to do 6 inch?
Yeah.
Okay. See if it comes off the roll now. Got music playing in here.
Nice.
Cut it on the table saw, make it smaller. I lost my blade. No, I don't. I have it right here. These sill plates. Let me do it this way. Get some protection here because I'm going to be going in and out of the vehicle 100,000 million times. Make sure that we get this little area right here protected. So now we got some paint protection film on the vehicle. I'm just gonna go ahead and pop this dash grill off. Supposedly there's a 4-inch driver in there, and then we also have down here in the kick panel. I think we'll go ahead and get most of the car disassembled before we try to get those out. Go ahead and get some of the stuff moved out of the way. I just want to take a quick look up here to see what's going on in the dash. See if I can get a pry tool in here. Looks like it's underneath the dash pad, so gotta definitely come. So, okay, so that just unclips. And then, yeah, it's about like a 4-inch driver. So, 7mm, that's a good assumption. It's either a 7 or a 5.5.
Yep.
But it seems like Ford went over to the 7mm.
And stuck with it.
And stuck with it, finally. That side could be 5.5. We don't know yet. Right, or 1's 5.517.
Yeah.
Yeah, so 7mm pops right out. And then, okay. Nice. So, all right, cool. So
that plug looks familiar, doesn't it?
It looks like either the Ford truck or the Mustang.
Mm-hmm.
One of the two. We'll have to check them. We have those here, so we'll have a plug, I guess, for that, so we don't have to cut anything. In this truck, we're gonna run wires.
Mm-hmm.
But we should have that plug. Cool. So yeah, 4-inch. Looks like a really high-end speaker. Little 4-inch full range, I guess. This seems to be the norm these days with car manufacturers doing like 4-inch or 3-inch. Well, this is actually bigger than most. Usually do like a 2 3/4 or sometimes 3-inch. This is a, looks like a 4-inch driver. So cool. So we got a 4 there, and then I guess set that aside. I'm gonna go look at that pod in the back. Remove my woofers out of the way. We'll go on the other side, Nathan, maybe.
The inside?
Yeah.
So you can let them see.
Boink. This.
Look at there.
Look at that. Okay. I think these just pop off. Look at that. Okay, so looks like the same speaker. It's a Philips.
Yep.
All right, but yeah, cool. Look at that. Looks like the same plug as the front right there. So that's good. So it's the same speaker, same little 4-inch two-tab front and rear. So we should be able to fit this guy in here. Looks about the same, almost. These tabs might be in the way, I'm not sure yet, but should be able to get that 4 right up in there, which would be great. And then we'll have to figure out where to put the tweeter. But that 4 will definitely fit, hopefully, in there. So I'll just push this back on for now. And then we'll go ahead and, Nathan, let's go ahead and work on sound treatment. But I think, according to a lot of stuff, I think the top will come off, which will help us tremendously with lighting and being able to see what we're doing. We don't really need the top for anything. These are mounted to this bar. The top comes off.
Yep. Feel less claustrophobic.
Oh no, it'll be wide open. It'll be great, man. You'll be able to see what's going on. Be able to get some good footage of this thing. So.
Cool.
Awesome. Let's do that. Let's go ahead and get the top off and find a home for it and go ahead and start jamming. Let it go when you were safe. We can run the center channel active.
Good.
Yeah. Be good. Just worried about that mid bass, Nathan. Hopefully it has enough mid bass. It's the only thing I'm worried about. It's definitely a better location than a Jeep Wrangler. Yeah. In those sealed boxes.
So it's not horrible.
Yeah. 150 hertz and up. So what do you say we call it a night? Or do you want to work more? You're down for whatever?
Whatever.
Whatever. I mean, you can start doing speaker wires.
Yeah.
That's what we need to do next. Or doors. I would do speaker wires first.
Mm-hmm.
You can twist them up. I can actually help you. We can twist them.
Yeah.
Pull them all. We'll twist them, label them, and get them ran. Might as well.
Still.
I'm done poking around. I got a process. Process what I looked at in my brain. Tomorrow I'll have all kinds of good ideas. So let's make speaker wires.
Okay.
So Nathan and I just made spaghetti. No. We just twisted these wires together. You guys can. They're all twisted now. We got them pairs, so now they're two speaker wires in each bundle. So now we have two 12 gauge, two 16 gauge for the left and right speakers, and then two 16 gauges we're gonna run in this vicinity over here for the center channel, which is not there yet, that we're gonna figure out how to do. But we're just basically prepping. So we'll run all of our wiring down this factory channel all the way back into the back where the amplifiers are going to go. Got those prepped so we can go ahead and get those laid in here. We have a bunch of other wires to run as well, so we'll figure that out. But at least we got that stuff prepped for now. We're slowly winding down for the evening. So I think
I say we prepped a little bit better than Ford, didn't we?
I would say so. They didn't do any prep. It's just kind of like tie wrap down. It's kind of weird. Very different, but it works, I guess, right? So we got it all prepped up. We can get these laid in here and then kind of do a little recap and figure out what's next. All right, guys, so today, I guess day one is a wrap. We had some goals. We almost met all of them. We got most of the wiring laid in. We got all the sound treatment done on the floor area in the back here. We still have to do the doors, the sound treatment in the doors tomorrow, first thing, and run some more wiring. We got mid-bass, mid-range, center channel, all that stuff prepped and ran loosely to the front. So we, and obviously we took the whole interior out of the truck too. That was a big, big thing. You can see it's all apart. Got the center console out. Obviously we had to do that to get sound treatment in here properly. And also today I did a lot of basically digging and exploring and figuring out, you know, fitting all this equipment that we have in this truck. I looked at the kick panel locations, determined that we already have a speaker adapter that fits, which is really awesome. I took a look at the doors in the front. I'm still up in the air on if we're going to do a mid-bass in the door or not. We'll see. I have to think about that a little bit more. I did a little bit of research online about possibly finding the pins for this particular connector so we can do this properly by adding some, there's some pin locations open in here. So if we get the male and female pins for both sides, we could populate those and actually add a speaker wire into the door location and make it unplug and the doors will come off no problem. Didn't really do anything with the dash location yet today. I kind of just sat a speaker up in there. I don't think I did that on camera, but I think I'm going to visit that tomorrow. What else, Nathan? What else did we do today? That's pretty much it, I think.
Found the radio.
Found the radio. Oh yeah, the radio's here in the middle of the dash. We know we have these plugs, so that's a tomorrow thing. So I think we accomplished a lot in the short amount of time we worked on the vehicle today. It was actually kind of a short day. We started around, what, 2 or 4 or something like that. We had some other things to take care of before we jumped into this project. So tomorrow we'll continue with running wires. Actually our power wire will be here tomorrow, which will be great. So we can get the power done. We can get the rest of the wiring laid in and figure out how we're gonna secure them to the factory channels and get everything. I think we need to rerun the center channel wire because it's a little shy. So we'll just repurpose that to run. We're gonna have to run. I can just open this. This door opens too. We gotta run. See, this is the factory rear speaker wire. We're actually gonna run new wires from there all the way down here and out to the amplifiers. I have to run 2 there, 2 here. Go over the enclosure with you guys, and then we can do some more treatment. I say we will probably end up sound treating the plastic panels in here. Pretty flimsy. Would definitely help with a layer of sound treatment on those panels. So we'll dig into this more. So tomorrow will be more treatment, more wiring, and a little more design stuff.